Here is a question in Arabic. I'll read it in English, possibly. Many Muslims who يعيشوا برزق الحرام, they are living with haram. They look at you and to the Islamic centers to take them لبناء مراكز عمل إسلامية تعمل بالحلال وتدار من قبل مراكز إسلامية بهذا لا يكون الفرد المسلم عبء على المراكز الإسلامية ولا المراكز الإسلامية عبء على المسلمين من حلال وحرام خاصة وأن مراكزنا دائما بحاجة ماسة. طيب, what do you want me to say? حلال, رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم سأل حلال وبين والحرام وبين وما بينهما كثير مشتبهات. حلال is حلال, حرام حرام. الله طيب لا يقبل إلا طيبة. Anyone who works in liquor stores is حرام. Don't tell me I have no other choice. No, you have hundreds of choice. رزقكم في السماء وما توعدون. There are two highways. One highway lead to Jannah, one highway lead to hell. Your rizq is being destined for you. You select the halal, it comes to you. You select the haram, it comes to you. Sometimes shaitan entices you to do more toward liquor store because it gives more money at one time. The other one is be delayed one day. But many of those who dealt in haram and product is either shooting or any catastrophe or robbing or sickness, whatnot. Choose the halal even if it is minimum. Now, our existence in America may be haram. Because why we are in America? Who told you to live in a kufr country? You're renting a house could be haram because you are paying the interest to the landlord who has to pay it to the bank. Put your money in the checking account without interest is haram because the bank is haram and using your halal money in haram. And your purchasing power of the dollar of today, next year it will be 90 cents. Even if you make 5 cents with CDs, also you are losing 10%, you are making 5%. Even if you put your money in your house and hiding it, you are losing the purchasing power from $1 into 90 cents plus. You are making much more than that. You are increasing the unemployment and depression and many other things like this. So everything is haram here. So where is the halal? I don't know. Show me the halal. So there are limits, no doubt, unless you are obliged. You want to do it, do it. But grocery, liquor, no, you are not obliged to do it. To sell even smoking cigarette, I don't allow it. I will never tolerate to see a single Muslim selling even cigarette, let alone liquor, because smoking is bringing cancer. I have so many relatives of mine died at the age of 30 and 40 because of smoking. And we know that here in America, smoking brings cancer. Why in the world? I was in business. I left most of my business. I didn't want to do any business anymore. One time they asked me in the Middle East, why don't you send us a cigarette? I said, no way. Once I was out of a job even, I was looking for any type of teaching job or academic job or research. The only one out of 300 application, only one application came. Milwaukee beer as a biochemist, research biochemist in the laboratory. I said, no way. I'm not going to even sit in the laboratory where I'm testing even the alcohol. I said, Ya Allah, I know you are testing me. I cried. I make Salat al-Hajjah. I got a job as a teaching job in one of the universities. You cry to Allah with Salat al-Hajjah, Allah will give you. You don't cry? Okay, Allah is testing you. What else? The other ones...